In this video, we're going to derive the three capacitor discharge equations for charge, current, and potential difference in an RC circuit. So let's start with the charge equation, which can be used to derive the other two. A good place to start is by considering Kirchhoff's loop rule. Assign V1 to the capacitor and V2 to the resistor, then draw a loop. The capacitor acts as the source, and the resistor is where the energy is dissipated, so it's negative. Our next step is to find out more about what V1 and V2 are. We get V1 from the definition of capacitance. C is equal to Q over V, therefore V1 is equal to Q over C. If you recall what a capacitor is, it stores charged particles and then releases them over time before dissipating them in the resistor. Therefore, Q is a function of time, and V is a function of time as well. V2 can be found by using the definition of resistance, so V2 is equal to IR. From our loop, we can see that V1 equals V2. Therefore, we can equate our two expressions for the voltage and get IR equals 1 over C times Q of T. Now, think about the definition of current. Current is the rate of change of charge over time, but what we want to do is relate this current to the charge on the capacitor. Current is a positive number, generally, but the rate of change of charge on the capacitor is negative because the amount of charge stored is being released over time. Of course, they are very closely related because the capacitor is the source of current in the wires. Hence, current is negative dQ by dt. Now, we substitute our derivative form of the current into our equation, and maybe you can see what's coming. We've now got a separable differential equation, and so that's relatively straightforward to solve. Divide both sides by R, divide both sides by Q, and this isn't quite rigorous mathematics, but multiply by dt on both sides and then integrate. The hardest part might be seeing what the bounds are, but since we want to go from some time 0 to some time t, we know that the charge is going from an initial Q0 to Q. If you're familiar with integration, these two integrals should be pretty straightforward, but let's go through it anyways. The left-hand side is ln Q minus ln Q0, which, using our log laws, is ln Q over Q0. The right-hand side is a simple application of the reverse power rule, so we get negative T over RC. Let's equate these expressions, and then using the definition of a logarithm, we know that e to the negative t over rc equals q over q0, therefore q of t is equal to q0 times e to the negative t over rc, just by multiplying by q0 on both sides. So that's our first equation. The current equation very much drops out of this one. We're going to once again use the fact that I equals negative dq by dt. So all we have to do is take the derivative of the first equation using the chain rule, and then take the negative of both sides in order to substitute our current in. Then consider the case when t equals 0. At t equals 0, I equals q0 over rc, because e to the 0 is 1. Therefore, q0 over rc is I0. These are both useful forms of the equation, so let's box them both up. The final potential difference equation is even easier. We once again use the definition of capacitance to see that the potential difference across the capacitor is Q over C. So if we divide both sides of our first equation by C, we can substitute the voltage in. So those are the three equations. If you have some questions, please leave them in the comments. And if you want to watch some of my other videos, including the derivation of the equivalent resistance formulas, click on the screen now. Thanks for watching, and bye-bye.